Oh, hello there. Who's there? My eyes have gone milky. Please come a little closer, sister. I don't believe we've met before. Why do you call me sister? I don't need sight to see someone who's also aligned. A dark contract. The woman looks blindly through you, though you can sense her focus. Contract? So you've had dealings with the damnable goat too? What sort of pact did he rope you into? Oh, you know how it is. I was young and he weren't no goat when I knew him. We used to dance naked under the blood moon and raise the dead to frighten dull country folk. But it's ancient history now. Old age comes for us all, and eventually you've got to hang up the sacrificial dagger and settle down into the comforts of retirement. I know the feeling. I miss my cozy chair and little fireplace. Seems like a fine spot you've got here. Oh, that was her. Whoops. Pay attention. Well, it's not all posies and pumpernickel. She clutches worriedly on the moth-eaten blanket in her lap. What's rattled your bones? Maybe I can help. It's my dear old husband. Handsome chap, although a bit clumsy. He had a tumbled trying to weed out some swamp traps from the yard. Awful things like to snap at your toes when you're not looking. Anyways, he twisted his ankle pretty bad and went off to the sick house to have it looked at. But that was a few days ago. He should have been back by now. And these legs haven't worked right in decades, so I can't even go check up on him. I've been so worried. I even thought about making another contract. Don't you dare. You just wait here. I'll go find him and see what the bother is. Thank you, sister. The sick house is down the road to the west. Be careful of critters along the way. They've got a taste for blood. Oh, poor old woman. Oh, can I catch this now? Ah, yes. A soot sprite. Find the shard in the swamp. Somewhere in the fens. The mirror's shard reflects the moonlight. Well, if I happen upon the sick house while I'm looking for this mirror, I could always help the old woman. Do I know how to make more of this bait stick? I'll need toxic thistle. I have not found any yet. But I do have meaty morsels and twigs. Perhaps I can find toxic thistle here in the swamps. rising body. Plant growth throughout has lifted this body almost to standing. Still dead, though. Oh. Propped up body. The thistles nourished by this body have grown strong enough to raise it up once again. I see. Plant punctured body. A forgotten corpse now anchored to the swamp by this thistles grown through it. Well, looks like the thistles are up this way. Here we go, some thistles. Thorny spines with a nasty afterbite. Handle with care. Let's try the, oh, hello. Shears. And what are you? A drake. Snackrifice. A juicy offering to powers greater. Powers with many gnashing teeth, useful against drakes. Oh, a snackrifice? Ah, I see. So if I have a snackrifice, I could harvest from the drake over there? Interesting. How do I make a snackrifice? Let's see. A juicy offering to powers greater. Powers with many gnashing teeth. Right. Soporific potion. Meaty, or no, not a meaty morsel. I need a roast beast. And also magic paste. And for magic paste, an omnipurpose miraculous adhesive. Dragonfly wings, fairy dust. And a jar of milk. I don't imagine that Drake is too friendly, so let's not get too close. Oh, but what if the shard of the mirror isn't right over there? Let's take a peek. Can't tell from over here. Let's venture further in this direction and perhaps we will find the shard over here. Oh, hello. Ouch. What are you? A stick totem. Someone built this effigy to pay respect to the moon. The moon in turn has given it life. If I have some snag vine, I could trap it. Let's see. Do I have everything for snagvine? Snagvine is an effective snare at some distance. It binds tighter as it pulls. Useful against pumpkin jacks and stick totems. Ah, seeker vine, I have some of that. Ah, sewing kit. I yet to have a sewing kit. But let's not get too close to that stick totem. Perhaps we'll be fine. What do we have here? Suspicious stump. It does look rather suspicious. Rot has given way here to something. The thick moss growing on this massive fallen trunk seems to recoil at your touch, revealing strange etchings on the bark below. Slowly, a spark of swirling energy seeps forth from the waterlogged wood until an ethereal doorway opens before you. Ah. An entrance even murkier than the swamplands around it. Perhaps this leads back to the gateway that goes back to my house. Well, I haven't found the mirror shard that's supposed to be here in the swamps. Oh, what are you? Hello. Poisonous newt. Exploiting its ravenous hunger, it is the only way one might secure it without touching it. I need bait stick, though. And it's poisonous, so let's not get too close. Some more seeker vine. Oh, well, don't you look scary. A troll, an impassable hook, unless perhaps he likes you. And another stick totem. Crude simulation of a human form, branches lashed together with scraps. Should we see if it likes us? Hello there. Fat troll sits squarely in the middle of the bridge, busy scratching an itch on its back with a fallen tree. His unmatched girth blocks the path forward. Out of the way, you big galoot! He shifts his mass and releases a loud fart as you attempt to circumvent him. Oof, fine, keep your bridge. I'll come back when the vapors have dissipated. Not very good manners. But what are the chances that mirror shard is up that way? I'll keep exploring. Oh dear. There's a bunch of those stick totems over there. Dancing totems. These are strange to begin with, but this one especially so. Am I any closer to the sick house? Take a look at my map again. Yes, let's head back this way. Down here? No. effigy. Such constructions are strange to begin with. Oh, there it is. Oh. Okay. These animated wooden effigies seem engaged in a ritualistic dance. They march in stiff patterns around a reflective piece of glass embedded in the soft ground. You lean in for a better look, just long enough to make out the shard's mirrored surface, reflecting the ghostly images of the moon. You think to reach in and grab it, but the swinging limbs of the dancing totems are too dense and quick. Out of the way, you overgrown twigs! Maybe I can get them to shift their attention to some other glittering bauble. Something shiny to trick these sticks. Something shiny. Let me think about this for a moment. What could I make? Perhaps a moonlight globe. Could be mistaken for a cosmic grapefruit, if not for its incredible radiance. I would need a shiny stone, totemic moondrop, and a glitter bomb. Easy enough. Let's see. A glitter bomb. I don't have an empty jar. I filled them with water. A soot sprite, I just caught one, and a flower petal. Okay. And what else did I need? Flower petal? I have plenty of flower petals. So I need another soot sprite and a jar. I might need to go back to the potter and get another jar made. I do have clay now.